Dustin McLean has asked us how to paint the wings of Kairos Fateweaver. Now, if you're painting Kairos, what you want to do is follow along with our Lord of Change painting video. But when you get to the wings, just swap out what you do in that video for what we're going to do in this one. So in line with that, I've undercoated a wing here using McCrag Blue, and we're going to show this to show you exactly what to do. You'll need Screamer Pink first of all to paint in the pinker areas of the wings, followed by Rack Half Flesh to start out the white bits towards the end. Then we'll need Druky Violet to shade all over the wings, and after that's dry, it's ready to start highlighting. So we're going back to Screamer Pink first of all for this, followed by Pink Horror, then Rakarth Flesh once more, followed by Pallid Witch Flesh. But we're going to be starting out with Screamer Pink, which I'm going to apply with a large base brush, and we want to put this on quite roughly. In fact, I've got an older brush to do this, because it's quite a large surface area to it. What you want to do is, as always, then you paint down with a little bit of water, and once you've got it ready, it's time to start applying. And what you want to do is, like I say, put this on quite roughly, and you want to go up to around about this point here and do a rough line running along so everything's kind of blue from about that point onwards. But underneath it, you want to paint the entire thing, and you want to repeat this technique on both sides with two thin coats of this colour. Once you've finished that, you're then ready to add some Rakarth Flesh to the wings, which we're going to apply in just the same way as Screamer Pink, but this time it's towards the end of the feathers like this, again quite roughly on like this, so that you don't get a solid line between one colour and the other. And this lighter colour runs all the way along the ends of these feathers, and then just a narrow band of it along the bottom here as well. With those base colours all applied, we're now ready to shade all over the wing with a good coat of Druky Violet. Once that shade is completely dry, we're going to go back to Screamer Pink to start to highlight with it. And this time it's a dry brush, just on the parts that you previously painted with Screamer Pink, not the lighter parts towards the end, but you do want to bring it up onto the blue and just lightly do it on the blue there, just to help bring those two colours together. Next, we're ready to start dry brushing with Pink Horror, and this one varies a little bit depending on where exactly you're applying it. What you want to do is get lighter the further back towards the blue you get. So when you're around here, you want to be very light and just get stronger and stronger right up to the point where you meet the Rakarth Flesh. And around here, you want to be as strongest as you are on the entire wing. Next, we're going to dry brush using Rakarth Flesh on all the parts that we previously painted with Rakarth Flesh. And what we want to do here is be quite heavy at the ends of the wings, but then very quickly get lighter and lighter as you bring it up onto the Pink Horror. And finally, apply a light dry brush of Pallid Witch Flesh. Still a little bit heavier on the very tips of the feathers, but this time you also want to bring the colour up a bit further. In fact, it's a good idea just to lightly highlight the ends of these feathers partway up the wings too, with just a very, very light dry brush like this. And there we are, that's all the feathers of this wing complete. So Dustin, I really hope that's answered your question, and I hope you enjoy painting the rest of Kairos Fateweaver as well. And we'll see you all again very soon.